The number one thing we walked away with, and we were genuinely surprised by it, and Kevin hit it on it this morning, we took to calling it audible data, but really, it's trusted data. We found when people started believing the numbers, when independent subsections of people could go take the number and test it to their norms and expectations, when they started to believe it, we found a profound shift in human behavior.
You know, we're seeing with, you know, better resource management, you know, a decrease in the amount of project challenges we have associated with what we call phantom resources. You know, those resources that are written on a piece of paper but don't actually ever show up. And we're seeing that decrease, and with the data we have and the good tools we're using, we're making better decisions. This strategic planning bucket is about knowing where our priorities are, knowing where our resource bottlenecks are, and being able to make those adjustments.
Make sure that management is able to anchor their business decisions in how in the resource management solution data, right? So if management can you know, show to the community that they're using this system to make real decisions, that actually might even overcome some of the other challenges that you have, such as around data, et cetera. But that's actually a pretty important part. Their business decisions in it, then the utility of the resource management system will increase for users, right? People will see that management's using it. They'll want to sort of put in their data so that so they understand it's being used to drive the business, and they're using the priorities that come out of the system to manage their thinking as well.
Management team that are, you know, potential constraints to your product development process or systems development process. Gives you an opportunity to explain what a gap means. So for us, the management was very hesitant to say we have any resource constraints in the company. When they saw red, they're like, you got to make the red disappear. You know, it wasn't a matter of are there people there or not to do the job. It was just red means bad, make it go away. So we had to deal with that. So that's part of the giving them the opportunity to react. So when you start to show them this data, they may fly all over the place. You know, there's no telling what your management team's response is. This can't be the reality that we're dealing with. And I have a story about that is I presented a report back to that packaging group I mentioned earlier that showed one particular resource that was about 240% allocated. And the manager of that group said, there's no way this data can be accurate. One of the packaging managers happened to get online late one night, saw that this resource was logged in. And they had a meeting with that resource and found out that person had been coming in for weeks at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning to try to get caught up on this job. So as most of us know, I'm not coming in to work at 2 or 3 a.m. for weeks at a time to try to get this done. So there's other things that can be a result of poor resource planning: motivation, morale, and employee turnover.
I have a software background. So, you know, I don't know how common it is with people that aren't in software, but so I looked it up on Wikipedia, and it's basically, you know, when you ask your computer to do too many things, it's constantly swapping, and it's changing from one task to another task to another task to another task, and the overhead with all that switching in and out is dragging the whole system down. It's just completely inefficient. So, and what caught my eye was this term here. I put it in bold here. So this notion of thrashing will continue indefinitely until the underlying cause is addressed. I thought that was very telling because, in fact, if you don't address your underlying cause of resource management, you're never going to get better at the bigger portfolio management. That's kind of a building block of good portfolio management.